Hey, this is Holly with Duries Out Livin. Today I am going to be putting some peel and stick wallpaper on the wall in the RV to give it some color. So to start, I bought some sheets of wallpaper. It's just peel and stick sheets. It's they're 4 foot long by 2.5 foot wide, and I got them from this site called Blik. It's B-L-I-K. It's where they put artists' works onto wallpaper. And you can see the one I picked is pretty sweet. It's got hidden birds and reds, and as you turn it, it's blues and greens and all kinds of cool colors and diamonds. And I did start already, so you could see a little bit of what I'm doing. I got one wall finished here. Looks really nice. It was not easy to line it up, so it takes a lot of patience and slow, deep breathing as you line it up. You can tell I have the plugs off the wall, so it'll be a little easier to cut. And besides the wallpaper, you'll need a pen and an exacto knife to get a good straight cut. And I just used an old piece of board to cut on just to prevent from going through to our new floor. And you can see I already cut, or already measured and lined, and use a ruler to make sure you get a really straight line. Doesn't have to be completely perfect, depending on how OCD you are. So here's my next piece lined up for this little skinny spot here, so I can fill it in. The wallpaper was only wide enough to go that far, so I'm having to do some filling in, and luckily it matches up. So I'm going to cut it, and then I'll be right back to show you how I'm putting it on the wall. Okay, so this is a different day. I, of course, have a toddler who keeps me very busy, so I had to put my last pieces on hold and continue today. So I'm going to show you how I lined up and cut it, and then we will put it on the wall. So let's see here. So you can tell I just measured. They always say measure twice and cut once. So I already cut the big long line here, right on the line. So I'm going to show you. It's pretty easy. You just make sure you follow the line with your exacto knife. And just keep focused as much as you can, which is not easy to do with toddlers around. And we're done. So let's just make sure, if for some reason it doesn't go all the way through, you just might need to do it again and press a little bit harder. And there we go. And there's our last little skinny piece for the top over here. So what I'm gonna do is just test it out by lining it up and make sure it looks good and straight, and then we'll stick it on the wall. Okay, so here I go. Wish me luck on getting everything lined up correctly. Sometimes takes a few tries. Luckily, it comes off and on pretty easily, which is good for those who want to make sure it's lined up perfectly. I'm just going to stick it up here so I have a little leverage, and then come down here and just line it up. And it's definitely not easy, but you just gotta have patience to get it looking just how you want it. Almost there. You can see it's starting to look flush. Make sure to press your fingers over the edges so it blends and get any bubbles out. And I'm actually going to take a credit card and just run it along the line here to give it a nice smooth edge. And then we'll be all done. So there you have it, peel and stick wallpaper. Awesome for RVs, awesome for rentals, or anywhere you just don't want to paint or ruin the wall with regular wallpaper and paste and make a huge mess with all that, which is no fun. Peel and stick wallpaper is awesome. So there you have it. Thanks. Have a great day.